I invented the electric magnetic toaster strudel.
Yeah, I just started rambling. I apologize. No. All right. And finally, in tonight's three and out, this was a part of your three and out sneak peek. And I do have to give some credit to our listener, Larry. Larry had actually sent me a message, and it was just simply, this reminded me of you, and it was a bird with a squirrel's head. So I started doing a little deep diving on the old interwebs, and I found an entire collection of people who have photoshopped animals together. So tonight's final three and out question is, who would win in a fight, the shark stang or the lepigator? Now, the shark stang is a Mustang horse with the head of a great white shark, and the lepigator is a leopard with the head of a, well, technically a crocodile. I just didn't think crocopussy was the proper name.
You can share your screen if you'd like. You have the option.
Oh.
Do you have the image? I was gonna pull.
You know, I don't. I am a 41-year-old man who barely knows how to log on to Zoom. How in the fuck do you expect me to share my actual screen?
There's a option at the bottom that says share screen.
Share screen.
Click that, and then it'll pop up the which screen you would like to share.
Are you guys really gonna? I am beat red right now. Where do I find this fucking option? Talk me through this. Do I go to video settings?
No.
All right, hover over your screen, and you see like a ribbon should pop up at the bottom. It says mute, stop video, participants. Do you see that on your Zoom?
I see participants, chat, share screen. Holy
yep.
shit.
Oh, boom, there you go. And then it's going to let you pick which screen to share. So find the one that has the picture.
And okay, click on share that. This.
Yeah.
Now we'll look. Okay, hold
there
on.
There we go. Bada boom.
Yeah. All right. And so now just get us back to.
Now find the picture I want to share. Is that what we're doing here?
Yeah. Basically.
Oh my God. I hope people.
Oh, it's right here.
Are...
It's right here.
How about this? Oh, this is going to be great for everybody who's just listening. Jesus fucking Christ. How's that? Can you guys see that?
Yeah. Oh yeah. Wow.
Okay. So at the top, if you can't see at home, again, this is a wild horse, a beautiful horse with a very glorious great white shark color scheme. The head of a great white shark, the body of a horse. And on the bottom here, we have a leopard with the head of a crocodile. And so the question is very simple. Who wins in a fight? The body of a horse with a great white head or the body of a leopard with a alligator slash crocodile complete entire head area? Alan, I have not started with you yet, so we will begin with you.
All right. I guess my initial question, because they're both absolutely horrifying. Let me just start there. But I guess my real question to differentiate becomes, like, are either of them encumbered by their horrific anatomical mashup? Like,
I think they're only encumbered as much as you imagine them to be. I think you look at them and you say that this is a freak of nature, God's mistake, and yet they are fully functional. Like, there's no, like, abnormality like beyond what they look like.
I'll tell you why I asked that question, because my concern becomes not so much for the shark stang. I think it may be the perfect animal. But the lepigator, my concern was that like massive alligator head can't be supported by the leopard body. But I'm going to assume that it can control itself and it's an apex predator as it is. So I am going to go, even though I called the shark stang an almost perfect animal, I'm going to go with the lepigator.
Okay.
And my reasoning here is because it's lower to the ground. I think it's got it should, in theory, have a greater top speed.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to chomp down relentlessly on one of these horse legs. Okay. Now, I don't know about you, but I've seen some horse races before, and I know what happens to horses who break legs. They don't make it very far. So I think that fact alone, the lower to the ground capability of leg crushing, really gives the lepigator one up in this battle. That's what I'm saying.
Okay, fair enough. Wesley?
Yeah. I'm glad we got all of the the potential just DNA mashup bullshit out of the way, and you know what deficiencies these things would obviously have. And I'm glad that the person who made it, was it Shark Stang?
Well, I mean, I named them. I just found the the pictures were made and on the internet. I named them personally.
That myself. Is its scientific name. Yes.
Shark Stang. It took the gills away, so it doesn't necessarily need to live.
Clearly, it has like regular lungs. Mm-hmm.
Admittedly, I did get a message. Does the Shark Stang breathe air? And the answer is yes. It is capable of breathing regular old-fashioned airborne oxygen.
Right. I say unlike horse thoroughbred horses that are bred to race. Those things are inbred just to be wiry and fiery as shit. Actually, wild horses are quite strong. They don't have the feeble or the weak legs that you're thinking. So okay. I'm just going to go by sheer weight. I think this thing it just stomps on that leopard, gator, or what crocopus or whatever the hell you called it. I think it just stomps it into the fucking dirt. It's got about 4 to 5 times weight advantage, stronger. Yeah, maybe it gets one of those front hooves and snaps around a little bit, but the bigger man wins. The Goliath beats the David.
Okay.
Now, I was torn on this one because especially Sean, who commented on our Facebook page, said Shark Stang, pretty much your worst nightmare in the water, but you gave it legs and a powerful horse body. Sorry, cat lizard. You're absolutely fucked. If I saw a Shark Stang in real life, I would just run straight into its mouth and save us both the time and frustration. Next question, please. Now, I agree that it does look like the perfect land/water predator. Right. But if you do notice, it doesn't have a neck. So the only way it can really turn to fight is by turning its entire body. And as you said, Wes, it is the bigger creature. And turning a battleship is a little bit difficult at high speeds. Now, the Lepigator, much like Alan said, it's got the agility of a leopard, but it also has that ferocious bite of a crocodile/alligator. Now, it also has claws. So, if it was able to broadside the Shark Stang, he's already going to have a few cuts to the ribcage area. Now, again, if Shark Stang gets one bite, it is over, okay? This is one shot, one kill for the Shark Stang.
That's fair.
But I think death by 1,000 paper cuts might be where I'm leaning here. Because, yeah, he may not be able to break the leg. Because you're right, wild horses are much stronger than these regular thoroughbred horses. But I just feel like that I just feel like the crocopus. I should have gone with that name, by the way.
That one's better, I think, yeah.
I feel like the crocopus, it's just so much more agile that it would just inflict, like, smaller but more sustained damage. And as long as it doesn't get caught, then it's the winner. And I have a feeling that crocopuses maybe travel in packs. I don't know. It just seems like a pack animal to me. But taking the pack animal thing aside, I think that any given Sunday you could have a winner here, but I'm putting my money on the crocopus slash lepigator.
Yeah, I had to say, in our long, storied history of doing these hypothetical animal battles, this one may take the cake. This one may be one of the craziest ones. Although I just was realizing that you did mix was it crocopus? That is a warm and cold blooded animal, so it might have some issues with figuring out how it regulates its body temperature, but that's fine. I understand.
Okay, well, I did also mix a water-breathing animal with an air-breathing animal. Mm-hmm. So,
also true.
You know, a fish and a mammal.
There's a yin and a yang.
And no one said anything about its tail either. That thing was, boy.
The Lepigator?
No, the Shark Stang.
The shark? It had a horse tail, though.
Yeah, I know. It was majestic. It was beautiful.
Well, yeah, but it's useless.
It looks like, you know,
it's useless for this at least.
Like, okay, whip so you're saying hair. much like Fabio's hair, the Lepigator would be distracted by the majestic beauty of the Shark Stang.
I think that's how he provokes the fight. He just like tugs it, like, and that's what sets it all off.
I'm just saying, like, I think I didn't even think about the claws thing that Mur brought up, but like, you ever seen a leopard hunt? They just hop on the back and they go to town. Now he's gonna have a harder time going to town with that long alligator snout, but he's still fucking that shark stang up.
Yeah, and Wes, you did bring up a great point about the how robust a wild horse is. Right. And all I could think of is kind of like what Alan was talking about. Could you imagine that the Lepigator going into the classic death roll at like 40 miles an hour, just coming in full bore sprint and then grabbing on with that alligator snout, crocodile snout, and going into the barrel roll?
Have you
it's pretty powerful jaws.
Have you ever